Hello and welcome to my channel. This is Armin, and in this video, I would like to show you how to calculate drag coefficient of a square cylinder in COMSOL. In this example, I will calculate the drag coefficient of a two-dimensional square cylinder with the Spallert-Olmarez turbulence model. Also, study is stationary. So, I will choose physics and study for the simulation from this way. Spallert-Olmarez is a famous turbulence model for the calculation of aerodynamic coefficients. It also requires fine mesh. I want to define the dimensions and inlet velocity in the parameters. In parameters, I'm going to specify the width and height of the fluid domain, inlet velocity, and side of the square cylinder. The dimensions of the domain must be large enough and the dimension of the square is not important. In geometry, I'm going to specify a rectangle for the fluid domain and a square for the cross-section of the cylinder. I'm using parameters instead of values here. Now, I have to subtract the square cylinder from the fluid domain. I specify an optional material. The values do not affect the drag coefficient. We can specify any material properties here. To generate the mesh, it is better to partition the geometry. I'm going to split the domain into four sections. Up and bottom are not sensitive to the size of the mesh. I use fine mesh for the middle of the domain and coarse mesh for the top and bottom domains. The velocity boundary condition is defined for the inlet and the environment pressure for the outlet. Symmetry is also used for the free field boundary condition at the top and bottom. Okay, it is time to define a proper mesh. I'm going to delete all default options. I'm going to define a mapped mesh for the downstream. Then I'm gonna use triangular mesh for the upstream and around the cylinder. I need to create a boundary layer mesh around the cylinder, because it is necessary to achieve an accurate solution. To determine the size of the mesh, I'm going to right-click on Free Triangular and select the size. In the end, I'm going to define a free triangular mesh for the remaining domains. The model is ready to solve, so I'm going to click on Compute and wait for the solution. The solution has been completed. Now the drag coefficient can be calculated. I first define an integral for the square surface. I'm gonna right-click on the results and select the 1D plot group. Then I right-click on it and select Global. In Global, I'm going to write the drag coefficient formula. I need applied force on the square, so I'm going to write the stress traction in the X direction. Then I define the integral for the traction on the surface. I define the integral after the solution, so I'm going to click on the Update solution to refresh the solution. As you see, the integral has been defined in the results. Now we have to write the drag coefficient formula. The area of applied force is the diagonal of square. You can also see the drag coefficient number in this way. Right-click on the derived value and select Global Evaluation. Then I'm going to copy the drag formula and click on Evaluate. Thank you for watching. Please like and subscribe to my channel.